Hello everyone, welcome to Study ATEC. In this video we are going to learn about single phase full control rectifier. Alright, so we know in the earlier videos we have seen that in case of half wave controlled rectifier with the effect of R load, RL load and RLE load, details analysis has been done. Now we are moving towards the circuit where we take the bridge concept, and they are the full wave type. As we know, the circuits or the rectifiers can be categorized as half wave and full wave. That is true in case of uncontrolled rectifier, in case of controlled rectifier also. In case of controlled rectifier, the half wave controlled rectifier discussion already has been done. If you have not watched those videos, please go through the playlist and find out. It will be better if you watch the lectures sequentially. Alright, now we are going to take the full wave controlled rectifier, which are two types. One is single phase full wave controlled rectifier. Later on we will take single phase half controlled rectifier. Single phase full controlled rectifier, single phase half controlled rectifier. Alright, so let us come to the point. So the circuit is pretty simple. Two thyristors are there in connected in this way, and two thyristors are there connected in this way. We call this portion to be common cathode. Alright, and here in the lower portion they are common anode, and the AC supply, single phase AC supply is given in between these two points, in between the anode and cathode of the first leg and the anode and the cathode of the second leg. And we have taken initially the resistive load, later we will change it to the RL load and RLE load, and we will see what happens. Well, exactly before coming to the circuit operation of single phase full control rectifier, let us discuss a small concept that will help us to understand every rectifier bridge circuits. Okay, so listen to me carefully. Let us take this portion, which is the common called the common cathode. All right, so let us say common cathode configuration can be something like this. Let us discuss with diode. Okay, because biasing of diode and thyristors are same, we are taking three. You can take more or you can take two also. Let us say this is a common, this is called the common cathode configuration, right? Now, let us say they are feeding with different voltages. One voltage, let us say plus 10 volt, and this is minus 5 volt, and this is say plus 2 volt. Alright, you can take different combinations. Okay. Now, find out which diode or which diodes will conduct. Okay. Yes, definitely the negative of this voltage source and this terminal are grounded so that current can flow, right? So we do not know which diode will conduct or which diodes will conduct. Okay, this is D1, this is D2, this is D3. Okay, so now let us blindly assume D3 will conduct. All right I do not know which diodes will conduct. We are taking blindly something, and gradually we will explore and come to the conclusion. First, if we assume that this D3 will conduct, so if D3 conducts, and if we assume that D3 is forward biased, so this is a short circuit, absolutely. So if this is short circuit, then this plus 2 volt will appear here. So this point's voltage will be plus 2 volt, right? Well, now think about this diode. This is plus 2 volt, this is minus 5 volt. Definitely, this is reverse biased. All right? Okay, fine. So this will be this is plus 2 volt, this is minus 5 volt, so this will be open circuit. All right fine. So let us come to this point. Okay, let us come to this point. To the diode D1, we see that this is plus 2 volt and this is plus 10 volt. This is definitely, this diode is also forward biased, isn't it? This diode is also forward biased, and if this is forward biased, so the logically this diode is a short circuit and this will conduct, and if this conducts, then this point's potential can no longer be plus 2 volt. We must assume this is plus 10 volt. All right so if this is plus 10 volt, assume about the D3. So this is having reverse biased. We assumed initially forward biased, but through this explanation we see that D3 can no longer be forward biased. This is just me reverse biased, so this is open circuit. So we see that whatever the point you start, you will come to the conclusion that D1 will be conducting, meaning in case of common cathode configuration, that diode will conduct which is having the highest voltage at its anode. All right, so this will be short circuit and this will make other diodes reverse biased. So remember this, in case of common cathode configuration, diode with max voltage at anode will conduct. All right, now let us take the different case, common cathode. Same thing. Okay, give the same voltages, plus 10 volt, minus 5 volt, plus 2 volt. Now let us start from this, again start from this, what will happen? We see that plus 2 volt, so this is D1, D2, D3. So if this is short circuit, this voltage will be plus 2 volt, and if this is plus 2 volt, this is plus 2 and this is minus 5. Alright, see here, this is plus 2, this is minus 5, right? So this can no longer be reverse biased, so this must be forward biased, and if this is forward biased, so this point's potential will be minus 5 volt, alright? So if this is minus 5 volt, what about this? We can see this is reverse biased, alright? Because this is minus 5 and this is plus 10. Remember one thing, the potential of the anode and the cathode, both devices, the status of the diode or the thyristor, whether it will be forward biased or the reverse biased. Right, because minus 5 is lower than plus 10, alright, so this is reverse biased, so this will be open circuit, and if this is minus 5 volt, again come to the previous one, if this is minus 5 volt, this diode can no longer be forward biased, what we assumed, so this will be reverse biased, so if this is reverse biased, then this is the stable point, this is a minus 5 volt, here the stable point was plus 2 volt, alright, sorry, plus 10 volt, which made D1 conducting. Here this minus 5 volt is a stable one and it will make D2 conducting. So what we see here, in case of common anode, the diode with the minimum potential at its cathode will conduct. All right, this concept will help you to go through the three phase, single phase, all the rectifiers. All right, so now coming back to the single phase full controlled rectifier with resistive load, and we have seen the diode or the thyristors are connected in this way, and we are taking the names T1, T2, T3, T4. All right, so I have given the names in this way, T1, T2, T3 and T4, diagonally the thyristors will conduct. Okay, so in the let us understand the circuit operation through the waveform analysis. All right, so we have taken here the supply voltages, the red color, and this is the VI. All right, and we will trigger the device. So in the positive half cycle, so this is the positive half cycle, what we can see in the positive half cycle, so this is plus and this is minus, right? So if this is plus and minus, what we can say, this is the common cathode configuration, which is nothing but this one, which was conducting here with a plus 10 volt, all right? So here we see that plus minus means two diodes are connected in common cathode, and this voltage is plus and this voltage is minus. What does that mean? This is higher potential, this is lower potential, all right? So which thyristor will conduct? From here we can understand that T1 will conduct, because this is having higher potential than this, which was this one. Okay, so we have discussed here with 3, you can take the 2 also. Okay, so this T1 will conduct in the positive half cycle, and here from the common anode configuration, that thyristor or the diode will be forward biased, which is having least potential, this is plus and this is minus, so this is the least one, so T2 will conduct. So what we can see in the positive half cycle, T1, T2 will conduct, here T1, T2 will conduct. Similarly, applying the same logic, you can say that here T3, T4 will conduct, T1, T2 will conduct, T3, T4 will conduct. Now, when this thyristor will be on, that is in our hand, so let us say we are triggering the device here at some point alpha, all right, and we are triggering the T3 and T4 at some angle pi plus alpha, all right. Again, here 2 pi plus alpha, T1 and T2 is triggered, 2 pi plus alpha, and here again T3, T4 is conduct, 3 pi plus alpha. So they are the triggering status of the the thyristors. So let us make a grid. Here we will draw the output voltage, and continuing this, here it will draw the output current IO. So first the segment 0 to alpha, right? In 0 to alpha, what we can say? So there is no question of T3, T4 is forward biasing. So T3, T4 is completely off. T3, T4 is off. So in the positive half cycle, T1, T2 will conduct. But before this point 0 to, before the point alpha is reached, before the point alpha is reached, T1, T2 is in off state. So what we can say, T3, T4 is already off, and yet T1, T2 is not triggered. So they are also off. So no switch is connected. So what we can say, the equivalent circuit is something like this. This is in off state, this is in off state, this is in off state, and this is also in off state. The alternating voltage supply has been given here, and the load is connected. All right, T3, T4 already off, but T1, T2 is not yet triggered. So no switches is connected to the source. So the output voltage will be zero. All right, so the voltage at the output will be zero. And definitely the current will also be zero. All right, voltage is zero, current is zero. Now what happens at the alpha point? At alpha point, suddenly we are triggering T1 and T2, right? T1 and T2 is triggered. So the equivalent circuit is this one. Equivalent circuit is this one. This is short circuit, this is short circuit, and this is positive and this is negative. Now what we can say, what will be the output voltage? This positive terminal voltage or this positive potential will appear at this point. Let us say this point is A, and the negative voltage will appear across the point or at the point B, and we will get the output voltage to be as an input voltage, ignoring the voltage drop across the thyristors. So we will get the output voltage something like that. The input voltage will appear at the load, so we will get the output voltage, and they will be in same phase. Same phase meaning max to max, because input voltage is output voltage, copy paste. And what about the current? We see the resistive load is here, right? And we have seen in case of resistive load, the voltage and current will be in same phase. So voltage and current is in same phase, because somehow the scale will be different, because Vm sin omega t divided by R equal to the current. So we get this scenario. And at this moment, we see the current through T1 and T2 is zero, which is below the holding current. That will make T1, T2 off again. And our equivalent circuit will be this one. Because in the negative half cycle, now come to the negative half cycle. In T3, T4, all right, in the negative half cycle, T3, T4 will conduct. But till this pi plus alpha point is reached, T3, T4 is also off. And the equivalent circuit is no switch is connected, and the output voltage will be zero. So we will get the output voltage at zero. Definitely the current will also be zero. Okay. Now at the point pi plus alpha, what are we doing? We are triggering T3 and T4. All right. If we trigger T3 and T4, the equivalent circuit will be this one. T3 is short circuit, T4 is short circuit. Now the polarity has been reversed to plus and minus, negative and positive. Now this positive terminal voltage through this T3 will appear at the point A, and the negative terminal voltage through the point T4 will appear at the point B. Again, though the input voltage has been reversed, but we will get the output voltage A as positive, B as negative. This is because of the bridge connection. So we will get the output voltage as positive, though the input voltage has been reversed. So this negative voltage will be inverted at the output voltage as this one. And what about the current? The same thing will happen to the current also. Max to max will be same angle with lower scale, and we will get some voltage something like that. And T3, T4 will be off here, because the current at this point is equal to zero because of the resistive load, and T3, T4 becomes off. And in the next cycle, these things happen again. And if the devices are continuously triggered, we will get the voltage something like that. This is a voltage and current waveform. Now we are going to draw, what about the current at the source? Now one interesting thing is here, that is the source current, meaning the we are measuring the source current here. We have to measure the source current here, Is or II, whatever you can say. It is better to say Is. So what we see that in case of positive half cycle, the current is flowing in this direction. Okay, this is the reference direction. So we will draw here Is. So this current which is flowing at the load, that current is the source current. Okay, fine. Because this current is flowing through T1 and through load. Okay, fine. So that is nothing but the source current. Now here zero current is flowing, absolutely fine. Then what happens here? Now in the negative half cycle, look, this point's potential has become positive. So current is flowing in this direction and coming back to this direction. Here it was in the positive half cycle, the current was in this direction. Now the current is in the reverse direction. So the source current will alter and the source current will be this one. All right. Look, the load current is unidirectional because of the bridge configuration. But the source current will alter in this way. And yes, you must write that this is Vm by R and this is Vm. Now we have to draw the voltage across the devices, T1 and T2, T3 and T4. T1 and T2 is conducting. Okay, so here the voltage across VT1, VT2. Here the voltage will be zero because they are conducting in nature. Here they are conducting in nature, they will be zero. Now in the other portions they are not conducting. Okay, here T3, T4 is conducting. Now when T1, T2 is not conducting, here we will get zero voltage because they are not triggered. This is also not in conduction. Okay, so no voltage is appearing across this device. Okay, we will get zero voltage. We get zero voltage here. Now in this portion T3, T4 is conducting. All right. So whenever T4 is conducting here, T3, T4 is conducting, we see that this positive potential, though the current is flowing in this direction, but this positive potential is appearing here. Okay. And the negative, this is positive here and this is negative here. So we will get the reverse biased voltage. All right. And this reverse biased voltage will be the input voltage. So we will get the input voltage here as the reverse voltage. So we get the voltage something like that. And again here we will get the voltage something like that. Similarly, when T3, T4 is conducting, we will get zero voltage. T3, T4 is conducting, we will get zero voltage. When T1, T2 is conducting, meaning this equivalent circuit, T3, T4, so we can say this positive voltage is appearing across the cathode, at the cathode, and the negative voltage is appearing here, we will get the input voltage, which will be appearing across T3 as the reverse voltage, and we will get the voltages something like that. And here. And we will see later on that These portions will be with positive voltages and negative voltages subsequently when T1, T2 extends its conduction in case of inductive load. Anyway, this was the waveform analysis for single phase half controlled rectifier. Hope you liked the video. Keep watching, keep building up the concepts. And one small request from our side, please subscribe to our channel so that we get motivated to make more videos. And share among your friends. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.